With such a big issue like climate change, we often feel, well, I'm just one person, what can I do? The reality is that our personal choices control about 40% of heat-trapping gas emissions in the United States. Our voting choices control much of the remaining 60%. So as individuals, we can certainly do our part. The first thing we can do is step on the carbon scales. It's pretty painless, although you might be surprised by the results. If you Google carbon calculator, the EPA has one, many other organizations have carbon calculators. You enter where you live, how many people live in your house or apartment, how far you drive, how much you travel for vacation, how frequently you eat meat, how you drive your clothes, what type of light bulbs you have in your house. You enter all of that into a carbon calculator, and then it tells you where your personal carbon emissions come from. Because for one of us, it might be travel. That's a big part of my carbon emissions. For another of us, it might be the fact that we like to eat steak dinner or barbecue every single night. For others of us, it might be that we drive a huge gas-guzzling car. But there's a different way that each of us produces the most carbon, so the first step is to figure out where it comes from, and then any good carbon calculator will give us recommendations. Hey, if you want the biggest bang for your buck, here's what you can do. Silly little things do make a difference. So for example, if every household in the entire United States, not every person, but every household, replaced one old-fashioned bulb, one traditional incandescent bulb, with a new LED, that would be equivalent to taking almost 1 million cars off the road. But individual actions aren't enough. We need more. And that's why it's so important to make our voice heard. There's many parts of the country, basically anywhere between California and New York, where most people don't think that humans are changing climate. But in those same places, between 70 to 80% of people agree that we should be supporting investment into a renewable energy technology, that we should be requiring our states to produce at least 20% of their electricity from renewable energy sources like solar and wind, and, amazingly, about 40% of people in the middle of the country support putting a price on carbon. So there are solutions that we can often agree to, big solutions that help us, that invest in the local economy, that ensure a safe energy future, that make us competitive with China. China is currently the world leader in wind and solar energy, and they have an emissions trading plan in place to reduce carbon, and we don't. So there's a lot of benefits to solving this climate issue for us right here in the places where we live, and we can often agree on some of those benefits, even if we don't agree on the reason why.